Good morning, Ned and Josh.
How are you?
Really well.
All right, Laura. Well, we've got you in this morning because you have a very, very interesting job. Can you just tell us what your job is and then we'll start asking you our allotted questions?
Yep. I'm a senior process engineer at the Molonglo Water Quality Control Centre in Canberra. I work in the operations team and we have a large team of operators and maintainers who operate the plant to make sparkling clean water.
So you turn sewage into clean enough water to go back into the river.
Absolutely.
Brilliant.
Fantastic. Yes. That is a fascinating job. Yep. And we have some questions lined up. Would you like to go first, Ned?
I can go first if you'd like. I feel like this may be, pardon the pun, starting it off in the toilet.
Okay. But, all right.
Does the treatment plant smell badly?
Not as bad as you would think.
Okay, right. Because I thought it would just be, like, I thought you would, I eventually imagine you would get used to the smell, but I feel like once you went there to begin with, you'd be like, oh, wow.
Most of the sludge actually that we produce is incinerated, so it actually comes out as an inert ash.
Oh, right.
So we try to avoid having raw sludge on the ground, so it doesn't smell too much,
yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
All right, so that's interesting. Good. First question.
I'm glad you thought so.
Next question.
I am biased, probably.
Yeah, but that's kind of what I know. Well, that was half of the question was, do you just eventually get used to it? But that I don't want you to ask because that's a second question that I've not been allotted.
Okay. I need to know right now, important things to not flush down the toilet. You hear condoms all the time, you hear baby wipes, all that sort of stuff. Is there anything that is worse or better in terms of the things you can't flush down the toilet?
So stick to the pee, poo and paper, please.
Okay.
The three P's.
Any product that's designed to absorb water, so that's nappies.
Yeah.
That kind of thing, they all expand. So that blocks pumps in the sewage system, wet wipes.
Yep.
And wet wipes don't actually break down like toilet paper does.
Well, so, yeah, they seem a lot more dense and they seem like they could take a lot more water in.
And they just don't break apart, which is what toilet paper does. So, yeah, generally those kinds of things.
What happens to... Oh, that's a follow-up question. I'm going to ask a follow-up question.
Well, then that's your second question.
Yeah, good point.
You can ask it. Go ahead.
No, I'm okay.
My second question then is, what is the weirdest thing that you've found?
Personally, my weirdest one is looking in the screening skip and seeing corn kernels. Like, I did not realise they made it. They make it all the way to the plant.
Oh, God, that's
and
disgusting.
They're separated from everything else.
Usually they're put into the furnace and we burn them because there's actually lots of energy in it, so we beneficially use it burning.
There you go, finding energy where I honestly would have probably been the last place I could have expected it to come from.
Anything corn can't do. Yeah. It can make petrol. It's amazing. Corn's amazing.
The funniest stories I've heard are things like ping pong balls. So any parents out there who are trying to toilet train their boys to aim, people, I don't know if you've ever heard, they put ping pong balls
I'll
in
just show
aim.
Them where to go.
Right.
Guys, they actually get flushed.
Yeah, that's
so
not good.
Well, you're not
they
usually
up...
picking them out, surely. You've got to imagine that
the
you're usually
worst
letting
game
them.
Of beer pong ever.
Yeah.
And then it seems like some people have gone, well, the ping pong didn't work. I'll try a golf ball. Because one of the fitters, the macerator pump stopped working and he opened it up and 15 golf balls fell out. So,
wow.
You can resell
rubber
those.
Duckies. Yeah.
Rubber duckies.
Rubber. So, yeah, I guess presuming that went down the toilet rather than the bath hole, but anything that can fit down the S-bend will make it.
So, yeah, well, that's it. People think they just flush the toilet. That's the end of it. No one else has to deal with whatever they've flushed, but you guys find it all?
Yeah. You know, we've had phone calls about people losing their rings or their false teeth.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, we have a lot of machinery that
churns it up.
Smashes it.
Yeah.
Right. The ring.
Yeah.
So, sorry, they're not coming back.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
My last question is... you often hear stories in cartoons and stuff about alligators in the sewer and all that sort of stuff. Do you have any animals, because the part of the plant's outdoors, isn't it? Do you have any animals that get right around sewerage?
Yeah, you'd be surprised. We've actually, we've found a beautiful green tree frog come into the plant.
Yeah.
We've often found snakes in wet wells.
Oh,
yeah.
So the poor
terrible.
Old snakes.
I don't feel too bad for them.
And it is a beautiful large site. We're next to a river wildlife corridor and there are big tanks like Olympic pool size tanks.
Yeah, right.
And we've got kangaroos bounding around. So occasionally there's the unfortunate kangaroo who takes a leap in the wrong direction and we have to get rangers to help rescue them.
Oh, wow.
That's the worst swim of a kangaroo's life.
He'll just avoid water from now on.
Yeah. Laura, thank you so much for coming in and having a chat to us this morning. We really appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Thanks for having me.